So okay guys, in this video we'll be doing the buff box from Hack the Box, and IP address is 10.10.10.198. I have already run the nmap scan to save some time, and you can see there are two ports open, 7680, and it is nothing. So when you connect with the netcat, it does not send anything. And another one is 8080, and it's running a web server, and you can also see it's saying the Windows 64 bit version. So we don't know which Windows, but it's a 64-bit. So let's go and visit the website. So there are some links here. You can go to the packages.php. So I have run the GoBuster scan, but it did not reveal much information. So all I have got is some pages which I have the access denied. So you can see there is some project worlds.in. So copyright to this projectverse.in, and these are the facilities. So it's about the gym center and about.php. So it's about the gym website, and here you can see made using the gym management software 1.0. So this is very software leakage, version leakage. So you can use a search exploit. Type gym. So now we can see we have the exact version here, 1.0, and it have the unauthenticated RCE. So we are going to use this one. So what you need to do is let's mirror this exploit. So copy this one and paste here. It asks for alright, yes, and then rename it to gym.py. So all you need to do is, you don't need to run or modify anything. It will upload a new PHP file, and that is the web shell. Okay, so you have to access the upload.php. So it does not check for authenticated user session. So it says some undefined index ID. So then what we are going to do is, we are going to name the file as kamehameha.php as a ID parameter, and then it is going to bypass the extension, and then the file gets uploaded. So it gets uploaded to this ID file name. Okay, so this is the code in Python. So this is the usage, Python URL, and I think that's it. So let's run this Python gym1.py. So if you run this, you'll get the exact usage. So all you need to do is just put the 10.10.10.198:8080 and run this. And you will get the web shell. So remember, this is a web shell, not a normal shell. So if you go to cd c, so you will be still in the gym upload. Okay, so you can see the file name kamehameha.php, which our script uploaded. Okay, now we need to upgrade this web shell to normal shell. Okay, first I have tried the system info. So then I came to know it's Windows 10. Obviously there will be PowerShell. So PowerShell, so PowerShell is 5. Now you can run this mini reverse.ps1, but it did not work. So I run this with the execution policy bypass, it still did not work, and also with the no profile, it did not work. Then I have tried this nc.exe, it did not work, but nc64-bit has worked successfully. So now we are going to try that. So we are hosting this entire folder. We need to download this nc64.exe and let's say it is a non 1234, so let's say or 2222. So you need to say PowerShell double get and use basic parsing. So if you do not add this one, it will try to open the Explorer to go to that URL specified. So we don't want to do that. So you need to check the skip the Internet Explorer check and grab the IP 10.10.16.190. /8000 and what is this nc64.exe and specify the out file and the current directory as nc64.exe. Hit enter. You should see the get request here. Yes, you can see get request for nc64.exe. Maybe the file is long, big size, that's why it's taking this much time. So completed. So there, now always try to use this exact path nc64.exe and execute a command prompt on connecting to my Kali Linux at the port 2222, right? So I think so, 2222. Now hit enter and you should see the prompt reversal. So this is the reversal. Now cdc, we do not type who the user we are running with. It's Sean. I think it's one of the user from the computers. So let's go to, so you can go to the users and you can go to Sean and you can get the user.txt. okay, after getting the user.txt, you need to escalate our privileges to the system. So WMIC has been enabled for us, WMIC OS rest brief. So this will give you OS information. So I think it's gonna take some time. Yes, we got the brief information about the OS. Now I have checked some for unquoted services and insecure services, but there are none. When I type the netstar ano to see the local processes or services. Now 7680, if you can remember, I think that's from our so 7680. And on the and you can see MySQL service is running because the website has been running and it also has the PHP myadmin. And you can see the connections here, the reversal. So there is one interesting port that is 8888. Okay, I think I should reset the box. So guys, now I have grepped through for this local 127.001. Now we can see there is a process on 8888. Now if you type the WMIC process, get name, process ID and executable path. So you will get the, I think we cannot see the port it's running on. Let me see the, so you can use the taskrest svc. So let's copy this. So I there should be an option for WMIC, so I will check that later. Now if you run this taskrest, it will show you all of the process. now crowdme.exe. So that is the binary it is running. Now let's go to cd root directory and dir recursive search for crowdstar.exe. Put the slash p to get the only path. Now hit enter. So now you can see C users Sean app data. So that is this software, and you can see in the C users Sean downloads there is actual the crowdme1112.exe. So so let's go to this downloads. Now this is the exe. So what you need to do is you need to get it out of this system to your Kali Linux. So use the NC64 and get it out of into your Kali Linux box. So I have already got this. So I rename it to crowdme.exe. Now what you are going to do is you need to test your setup. So Windows 7 32 bit. Okay. So let's minimize this. I'm going to close this Chrome because I want to start this Windows 7 and Kali Linux. So my RAM will be almost full. So let's start this. So we need to fuzz it and see whether it we can gain control of the instruction pointer or not. So the name of this box is buff and it indicates that we need to do the buffer overflow one. So we can also use the you can see we got the version right, crowdme 111. Let's say buffer overflow. So now you can see here crowdme sync buffer overflow. So you can choose this one. You can also use this exploit, but we are going to build it from scratch because it makes somewhat you can get grip of it, this making exploit. So okay, that's what we're going to do today. So let's write raw socket code. So we are going to generate create IP version for TCP socket. So let's just save up to here. Okay, so this is the binary file. So you need to double click on this. It will ask you for setup. After that, what you need to do is you need to create an account. You can just give a normal email. Then the software gets installed. So now click on start and search for cloud. So CloudMe. So you need to run this one. After running that, it will automatically start at the startup. So it will always run on port 8888. So it is running on the local host. It's not on on all interfaces. So we cannot connect to this port. In order to connect to this port, we need to port forward. So let's use the chisel. So you can grab the chisel from GitHub. So chisel server minus port 3333 and reverse. So we are running as a server on the port 3333 and reverse. So this reverse option allows the Windows 7 client to open the port on our machine and connect to the destination we specify. So this is the server, and now what we're going to do is, so I have already copy pasted the chisel binary to this Windows 7 desktop. So chisel.exe client, and the IP address of this curl Linux is this one, 192.168.0.100. Now copy this colon, so the port number which you are running as a server is 3333. 3333, and then what we are going to do is we are going to say the R as a remote, that is the Kali Linux or any other incoming, say 4555 colon. So this is the source. Okay, so now we open the port 5555 on Kali Linux, and whatever the data I throw at that port will be sent it to this destination. So to what destination I need to send, that is 127.0.0.1:8888. So that is the port this CloudMe is running. So now run this and it's just connected. Now you can check with the netcat and see, and 5555, now you can see the port is open, but you do not get any data. So we need to send the data. So to what connection we need to send the data is localhost 5555. So it will be forwarded to the cloudme.exe. So okay, before catching any crash, we need to observe the crash, right? So open the immunity debugger, and you can see the CloudMe is already running. So if you, the process is running, you can attach to that process, click on file and click on attach. Now you can choose all the binaries here, click on CloudMe and click on attach. Now it may seems like it hang for some time. So you can, what you can do is you can restart this one, restart, and click on this pause button to run the binary. So after connecting to this one, what we are going to do is we are going to say junk, let's say let's say we are going to send like 2000 yes. Payload is equals to junk, and payload is equals to, we need to encode this entire payload raw Unicode escape, so that the characters will be exactly what you send here, it will be shown in the buffer. So we going to send this payload. So after sending the payload, we can close the connection. So that's right. I think we are good to go. We are connecting to our 5555 and we are sending the 2000s. That will be port forwarded to the 8888. So the binary is not running. So let's run this. So now it's running and let's save this one. So now, okay, we did not crash. Okay, it took some time to receive the data. Now you can see all of the yes. So EIP contains yes and ESP contains yes. Now scroll down, you can see there is a lot of yes. So you can write the shellcode here. So let's restart this. So it's a vanilla buffer overflow. So MSF hit the tab key 2 times and you can see all of the binaries. MSF pattern underscore create and length is 2000. So this is the unique pattern. Copy this. So instead of junk, we are going to send the unique pattern so that we can find the exact offsets of instruction pointer and stack pointer. And let's save this. So it's now it's running. Now run this. We need to run again. So let's run it again. So okay, now you can see ESP BJ2B. So let's copy that. And if you scroll up, it will be exactly EIP. So you can see the contents of EIP as well. Now this is the ESP. So copy this. And we can use MSF pattern offset and Q for query. And you can see we have the exact match at 1056. And obviously EIP will be 1052. Because it's just 4 bytes backward of the ESP, right? So 1052. Now what I can do is if I write 1052 yes and then EIP let's say B's, then ESP C's, 4 C's, and then it will be correctly put into the EIP and ESP respectively. Now I can say junk to as a D into let's say 2000 minus length of this junk EIP plus ESP. So it's a good way of adjusting like this. And if you manually count this one 1052, 1056 and 1060, if you do it from 2000, it will be like 940. If you put 940 here, whenever you want to change this one, then you need to change this. So instead you can dynamically you can dynamically delete the calculate the length and delete from the. So this way makes the exploits readable. Now I think we are good to go. Save this. Okay, my bad. We did not change the actual payload we are sending. First one is junk, right? So this 1052S will go into the buffer and up to EIP, and the next 4 B's will go into EIP, and next 4 C's go to ESP, and the remaining will be filled by this. So let's restart this. Junk EAP plus ESP plus junk 2. So let's save this. And when you run this one, so let's send this. So now you can see ESP exactly have 4 C's and EIP 4242, which is the hexadecimal for capital B, that is this one. And you can see we have the perfect control over EIP, and at the ESP we can write the shellcode. So let's restart this one. Now our task is to find the jump to ESP instructions. Now I have already put the mona in, so close this one. I have already put the mona in the this C immunity debugger py commands. So all you need to do is mona jump register to ESP. Now hit enter. Now if you observe, we need to this is the Windows 7 32 bit and our Hack the Box box was Windows 10 64 bit. Okay, so what we are going to do is we are going to find the application DLLs that contain the jump ESP instructions. So this take a while because this application DLL when compiled from the manufacturer contains the same address. Alright, so those address will never change regardless of operating system. So if you choose the operating system DLL, then it varies, the address varies from OS to OS. So if you prepare the exploit for this Windows 7, then in Windows 10 it will not work. So that's why for this kind of success we need to find the application DLLs. So view, you can click on view log and you can see so total of 397 pointers. So let's go to working directory, C, mona and cloud me. So there is a jump.txt. So maximize this and scroll down until you find jump ESP. So there you go, there is jump ESP and you can see all the security mitigations are false for the Qt5 core DLL. So that is the, you can see the path here. What is the path? Cloud me Qt5 core DLL. So that means this is the application DLL. So this is perfect match for us. So let's copy this one. Now you can just see, let's paste this here. Jump ESP Qt5 core.dll. So now you can see the normal bad characters 00 0A 0D, so there are not any. So let's first let's see let's put the breakpoint here, 4 breakpoints, and then 7B. And I'm going to write this address in the reverse order because it's a Deuterium byte order. So that's why we need to write in the reverse so that whenever you send the data, it will be in the exact this address 7B, 8A, and next is A9, and the next is 68. So I think I put the correctly 7B first one. And 8A, 8A, A9 and 6A. So perfect. So now let's try ready to run this. Now close this text file and click on view CPU. So now the application is running. Let's run this. and you can see the four breakpoints. Step through this, step through, and breakpoint. So let's restart this. Perfect. So we have the control over this one. Now we are going to create MSF Venom. So this is the code. So this is the we need to say we need to execute. So this is the Windows Shell Device TCP localhost is 192.168.0.100. Port is let's say 6666. ifconfig. So now hit enter. Also reason, let's reason on 6666. So let's copy this one. And instead of these breakpoints, put the knobs, let's say 40 knobs. So these knobs just does not execute any instruction. Then these after EIP, these knobs gets executed and nothing happens. After that, our reverser gets executed. So let's ready to trigger the exploit. Now the application is running, and our listener is running. Now enter. Okay, my bad. I know where I did the wrong. So I did not put the reverser here. ESP plus reverse underscore shell. So that's why there are this. Now it's running. Now run the exploit. Think it should take a minute. So now we can see we got the. So who am I? So this is the computer. So now we are going to change the IP address for our 10.0 adapter. 10.10.16.190. So Windows 7. So okay, let's close this. So okay, now our shellcode has been generated. Let's copy this. And now let's delete all these lines. And then paste the shellcode here. So this should go to our 10.10.16.190, right? So let's save this one and let's ready to trigger this. Even in this buff box, it's running as a local host. So we need to transfer the chisel, and then we need to, let's say ls. So where is this? So there you go, in my desktop it has the chisel.exe. Now we need to get it to PowerShell. Let's get the chisel into this folder. Since we are the Shan user and this is the Shan downloads, I think we can write to this. So it will take some time because chisel is like 17 MB. We can see, let's run this now. 3333 port, we are running the chisel as a server. Okay, now chisel has downloaded. Now I can say chisel.exe client 10.10.16.190 and the port is 3333, right? Yes, 3333 on connecting. So anyone from the Kali Linux box, open the port 5555 and port forward to localhost 8888. Now after hitting enter, you will use the access to the okay, I don't know why there is, I missed the 4 threes. My bad. So we got this. Chisel.exe client 10.10.16.190 and 3333. So 4 threes, and then open the port on 5555 and whatever data coming from that port and redirect to 8888. So now it should connect. So it's connected. Now you will use the access to this terminal, but don't worry, make sure we are listening on 6666. and let's run this. Now if you run this, you will get the shell. So who am I? Administrator. So now you can go and grab the root.txt. So this is this box. So this is very good box because it's simulates like real world. There is a software running on and you can get onto your local system and then you test the software, build exploit to it and run on the server.